Today we are with four MEPs in our programme Ask Your MEP, talking about Brexit. Janice Atkinson, what do you think about this cover? Because all over France we see this lines, Europe without English. Do you think that Brexit is about leaving Europe?
No, it's not about the English. Actually, England is made up of Great Britain, and it's Great Britain that will be Brexiting and leaving the European Union. And actually, we're not leaving Europe. Europe is a fantastic continent. You know, we've got so much in common with our culture, our identity, our history. So we're not leaving Europe, but we're leaving this sclerotic place, which is the European Union. So that's very, either they've got the language wrong, or they're deliberately misleading people about what this means. And this debate is going on at home, actually, as well. They talk about leaving Europe. We're not leaving Europe, we're leaving the European Union.
What do you think, Mr. Annemans? What do you think it will hurt your country, Belgium? Because de facto, Brussels is the capital of the European Union. So would it be a blow to your country, to your capital, if there will be Brexit?
No, not at all. We want a Europe that is, in essence, based on diversity, not being all the same, not being in one artificial state. So we Flemish patriots, we know what it is to live in an artificial state like Belgium, and so we don't like to cover it by an even bigger artificial state. So getting out of the European Union is a dream for all the people, or should be a dream for all the people, enhancing the diversity, which is in essence Europe itself. So Europe is not the European Union. Never talk about European Union when you mean Europe. And so we'd like the British to go out, not to get them out of Europe, on the contrary, but to get them out of the European Union, showing us the way to do it, and showing also that they will not disappear into a black hole, but will become themselves the guiding people for the exit of European Union.
Harald Wilemski, Austrians, they are concerned with Brexit because it's rather far away geographically, but also economically, I suppose, you have not so many ties as Dutch. But how people feel about it, you, in a way, supporting Brexit?
I don't think so that Austria will have negative influence of Brexit, but I think it's the most noble way of doing politics to ask the people what they want to do, how they will decide about their own future. And I am absolutely supporting Janice and the idea of Brexit, because Great Britain is a very big country, and if a majority of Great Britain votes for Brexit, in favor of Brexit, I think there will be no damage either for Austria nor for any other country.
Referendum. We are coming to referendums because that's what you mentioned. Yeah. So, Mr. De Graaf, what do you think? It will reinforce the desire of Dutch to have one more referendum like British for Dutch exit. I don't know how exactly we can propose
Nexit,
it because
yeah.
Yes, because our Nexit, we have already the word. So because now many people in this house disliked the idea that you had referendum on association with Ukraine. So you have an experience to push through your ideas.
Absolutely. We already had two referenda concerning the European Union in the Netherlands. And both times the people actually gave a big no to the European Union. First it was about the European Constitution, this time it is about Ukraine agreement, but basically it was positioned as a vote about the European Union. And it was a clear no. It was about two-thirds of the European of the Dutch population said no to the European Union. So a Brexit would definitely enforce the call for a same like referendum in the Netherlands.
Our Janice Atkinson, now it's turn most probably to talk about your book. So why you decided to put it all on paper, why you decided to gather, assemble the opinions of your colleagues and write this book? Mm.
Because the debate at home is about the xenophobic little Englanders that want to leave Europe. And as we know, we're leaving the European Union. This brings a European perspective to the argument, which we're not having at home. My partners, we've now got 9 partners in the ENF group. They all support taking back control, national sovereignty. It should be the nation states, their own parliaments, that actually decide our laws. 75% of our laws are made in this place. A German study showed that 84% of our laws actually come out of here. And we've all come together as a group because we believe in our own national sovereignty, taking back control of our borders and immigration. That argument is being had at home, but what's not being had is it's the Remain campaign are trying to frighten people. This is not what Europe wants. This is not what the European, our European partners want. They won't trade with us. This book actually demonstrates that they will trade with us, the Dutch, the Austrians, the French, and the other groups in here. And it's making their case about why they want to take back control from this place and why they're backing Brexit. Because it's actually because if we leave and we start the crumbling of this place, the whole edifice will fall. And so that's why they're looking to us. And that's actually written quite clearly in the book as well. But it's actually putting a European perspective on Brexit and what it means to the other nations too.
Mr. Annemans, why you participated, why you decided to write for this book?
Well, as I explained, this thing of the British referendum, the British taking the lead out of the European Union, is a sign of hope and is a sign of it's a strategy towards a better future for all of us, because Europe cannot be built on a unity like this, on a forced unity like this, with migration policies, euro policies, monetary policies that destruct the real European structures of economy, of peaceful living together, etc. And so this European Union should be turned back. And the British are have the splendid opinion and I would almost say the luxury to be able to vote on that and to be able to get out of it. They should take this opportunity and we are in some sense quite jealous that they would have, that they will be the first to do so, and we will follow them. We hope to be able to follow them someday.
Just now, Janice said there is campaign in Great Britain and also in Europe, like scaring, like with Hitchcock movie, about the consequences. So do you feel that press in Belgium is also playing this game? They also are trying to scare that it will be the end of the world, apocalyptic scenario. Do you think it takes place?
Panic. The regime is in panic, of course, and they call up on Obama and got himself, if necessary, to show that if you go out of European Union, you end up in hell. And of course, that is not the case. The British will be our friends like they were before. They will have better opportunities to deal with us, and I think that once these relations of not forced unity but cooperation, freedom cooperation, freely cooperated people, cooperating people, once this relation has been established, we will be better off.
Now it's your turn, I suppose. What was your motive, what was your inspiration when Janice proposed you to write for this book? What made you agree to do it?
I was honored to support it because I support everything which helps to reform this European Union. And I'm absolutely with Gerolf Annemans. The European Union is not Europe, it's just a club. And when you're a member of a club...
No, it's not true. They are not leaving Europe. No.
It is true. And you can either try to change the rules of this club or you can leave this club. Yeah? Mm-hmm. And this is based upon the decision of every member to stay or to leave. Yeah? And I think that Great Britain will also take part in a Europe-wide cooperation with all the other nations to work on our freedom, to work on our friendship, to mm-hmm. work on a good common future. Yeah? But that is something completely different with the European Union.
What about Dutch? So your participation, how you will describe it?
What I would say is the European Union is like a train being driven by Germany, by Angela Merkel, basically, and it's going on top speed towards a concrete wall. Mm. The only, well, the country profiting most from the European Union at this moment is Germany, at the expense of all other nations in the European Union. And we fiercely believe that by exiting the European Union, it will bring back prosperity. Prosperity to the Netherlands, but also prosperity to other nations like the UK. And we had a research on that by a very renowned institute, Capital Economics, who actually demonstrated that we would have a very significant positive effect when leaving the European Union. So when we got the request of a contribution towards for this book by Janice, well, I immediately said yes, because I think every British voter should know that the United Kingdom will really profit from a Brexit.
What families get from that? Because, sir, what's the profit of each family? Because you are calling each family to vote Brexit. So how you motivate your call?
Okay, we have to explain to people the damage that VAT does. We have no control over VAT taxation. So if we come out of here, we can take VAT off fuel, basically electricity and gas and other utilities. Because of the green policies in this place, electricity bills are around about 20% higher than they actually need to be, and that's very damaging. There's a thing called the tampon tax. You know, women have to use sanitary products. If we come out of here, we can actually take tax off of sanitary products. We can't do that all the time we remain in here. There is an argument that the Institute of Economic Affairs in London estimated that it costs every family about £700 extra a year on high food prices because of unreformed common agricultural policy. Now, because we are in it's supposed to be a customs union, it isn't. It's excluding the rest of the world. We keep Africa in poverty because we hand them aid. We don't actually trade with them because we've got trade barriers. So therefore, sugar is more expensive because we're actually propping up the Polish and sugar beet. But we've got a good tradition in our country with the sugar manufacturers, where we're supporting rural and deprived economies around the world. We have to put trade barriers up against them. So sugar is more expensive, wheat's more expensive. Everything that we buy outside of the European Union costs more money. That drives up prices. Our common fisheries policy, if we were to reform that, we can take back control of our waters. Fish will be cheaper. We'll be conserving the fish rather than having the French and the Spanish actually raping our waters, because that was a dirty deal that's been done here and successive British governments, I might add as well. And that's seen a decimation of our fishing fleet. So if families vote for Brexit, they're actually going to be better off in their pocket rather than having our VAT controlled by this place.
My last question, Janice Atkinson, where one can get this book? Because we understand there are a lot of explanation here and a lot of objective information. What are the consequences of Brexit to European Union and to Britain?
Okay, well, you can go onto my website and apply for a copy and we'll send it to you. It's free, but also it will be available online very, very shortly. So again, go to the website. It will be available on Kindle and Amazon. It will be free. After a short while, there'll be a nominal fee because that's the rules of Amazon. We have to pay 99 cents, but it's a bargain at 99%. And this actually will save our future and our future generations of children.
Thank you, everyone.